2-4 hours with Google Colab Pro. So if you want to buy this subscription, do buy it. So hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Trashman. So today in this video I'm going to explain you that how you can do your render freely. If you are using Blender, then this tutorial is especially for you, so that you can now do your render animations freely. Watch the video till the end so that you will get full information that how you can do your renders freely. This video is specially for Blender user. If you are using Blender software, then watch the video till the end because this video will be most informative to all of you. If you have used 3D software before, then you know that once you have created any kind of animation in any software like 3ds Max, Blender, Cinema 4D, we have to do one last process which is known as rendering, which is the most important process as we all know that once we do the rendering, we get the output that we required once we have done the 3D animation works in the 3D software. But we know that when we do renders, the most important thing is that if our PC specs are high enough, then we will get the render quality, as well as we require less time to render that particular frames or particular frame segments. But if you have less specs PC, if you have only 8 GB of RAM and some low cost GPU, then this video is for you, because in this video I'm going to explain you that how you can do your render freely. So this is a website known as Google Colab Pro. This video is especially for Blender users only. If you are a Blender user, then it will be easy for you to render now. Where it was taking 3 to 4 days for rendering just 400 frames. If you watch this video till the end, then you will just need 4 hours to render 400 frames. So the website that I was talking is Google Colab. So basically Google Colab provides best kind of GPUs for you. It is a free website, but if you pay some amount, then you can use high-end graphic card for renderings, as well as the rendering time will automatically reduce from 3 minutes to 1 minute or 30 seconds. So if you buy the paid version, then it will be very useful for you. So without any further ado, let's start the video where I'm going to explain you that how you can do renderings in Google Colab Pro, as well as I will give you some codes. The codes will be in the description, so go check the description, you will get that code that I have used to render my videos, as well as you can see some videos that have been rendered using Google Colab Pro, and the time that I have that it needed to render was just for one frame, it was 30 seconds to 1 minute, and the graphic card that I got using Google Colab Pro was Tesla P100 and Tesla V100, which if we see the cost of Tesla P100, then it is, and if we see the cost of Tesla V100, then it is a big price if you want to buy this kind of graphic card. But with Google Colab Pro, we get it for free. And if you are using Google, I am going to explain you what kind of pros and cons you get in the free version and in the pro version. So watch the video till the end so that you will get full knowledge that how you can use it. So I am now going to explain you that how you can use Google Colab Pro. So you can see the screen where I am explaining you as well as. So first you have to go to Google and type Google Colab. Once you have typed Google Colab, you can see my screen. Then you have to create new notebook. Once you have created that new notebook, then you have to run some codes, as well as you have to run some runtime, and you have to change that runtime to GPU rendering and just click OK. Once you have done this step, then you have to run some codes. I have provided these codes in the description box, you can check it. and just copy that code and run that particular code. I am going to explain you that particular code that what it will do. Yeah, and then you can see that first code. Hello friends, so now I'm going to explain you that how these codes work. So let's start the video. So as you can see my screen, that you are seeing some codes like import PSUTIL. This is some codes. Then there will be four main codes that you have to put in the notebook sheet. So first is this code import PSUTIL. Then the second code that you have to put is NVIDIA/SMI. So I have provided all the codes in the description, you can check it. And the third code that you have to put is this particular code which says that Blender version used for rendering the exclude the cell. So you can from here you can set the different Blender version like Blender 2.90, Blender 2.91, Blender 2.92 as well. As in this particular video I am going to explain you about Blender 2.90, but you can set Blender 2.92 as well as. So in the next video I'm going to explain you that how you can do that particular thing. But if you are using Blender 2.92 and you want to render in Blender 2.90, you can do that also. So the next code that you have to put is that you can see this code which is from google.colab import drive. So you have to click on this play button, and once you have clicked on this play button, then you will have to copy some link or copy some code into this particular slot. And once you have pressed enter, then it will automatically mount at that particular Google Drive. And keep it in mind that you have to create one Google Drive, separate Google Drive, or you can use your particular Google Drive also into your Google Gmail ID. So once it is mount, then the fourth is that you can see that from google.colab import drive, then you have to just press the play button which is you can see which is here, and it will also show as mounted /content/drive. Once you are done that, the most important thing that now comes is that how you can do your particular render from Google Colab or Google Colab Pro. So this version is Google Colab Pro. So I am now going to explain you that how you can render it, and then I am going to explain you that what is the cost of Google Colab Pro and what is the pros and cons of Google Colab free version. So for this version, so now let's see the next code which you can see is sudo/blender/pset. This is the code. So now what you have to do, the main thing that you have to do, you have to upload your particular blend file into your Google Drive. And keep it in mind that you have to upload both files like blend file as well as .blend file, where you will get all the textures of that particular Blender files. So once you uploaded both two files into the into your Google Drive, then what you have to do is the main thing that comes now. The first link you can see that, or the first code you can see that, which shows that content drive my drive slash particular name that you will that you have to put, like if that here you can see particular name. So if your file name is like cave, then you have to put the cave name here. And if your file name is like bike render, then you have to put that particular name like bike render. You have to write here, or you have to type here. Then you have to again type that what should be the name of that render frame. Like here I have already written cave. If you have written any bike render animation, then you have to put that same name. and then you have to put .png.targa.jpg, whatever format you want that to be rendered, you have to put it here, and then you can see this F78 or F1. F means frame number. So this particular code will run just one frame, and if you want to run animations like from 1 frame to 100 frame or 1 frame to 500 frames, then the next code is this, the code which is down below is the next code, which is also the same. You have to put your name of that blend file, then you have to put what name you have to generate that render output name. You have to put your name, and just keep it in mind that you can see there are four hashtags. So if your render is like 500 frames, then you have to put 4 hashtags. If your render is of 100 frames, then you have to put 3 hashtags. If your render animation is like 20 frames, then you have to put 3 hashtags. So in this manner you have to put the hashtag. And now if you want to render like 1 to 100 frames, then just you can see here some number like S1 to 100 or S201 to 300. What you have to do is just change the number, like from 1 you have to put it start, you have to put at 1, and the end number you have to put at your particular animation frame, like 300 400 500. And once you have done this, then you have to just click on the play button. If you want to render single frame, then you have to then you have to click on the first or the above code and click on the play button, then it will start rendering. You can see the display, and once it is completed fully rendered, which hardly take 1 minute in this particular PC, which is Tesla P100, you can see in the NVIDIA/SMI section that it is Tesla P100. So once you have completed that particular frame render, you can directly go to your Google Drive account, and you can see that it will be available on Google Drive. Then just you can easily download your particular render. So now I am going to explain you that what is the difference between Google Colab free version and Google Colab Pro version. So wait a second. I am opening Google Colab Pro version that I have purchased and I am using from a while. So you can see that I opened the Google Colab Pro version subscription. You can see that I have already subscribed to this subscription of Google Colab Pro. So it is of just $9.99 per month, and you can cancel at any time. So if we see Google Colab Pro and Google free version, so first I will talk about Google Colab Pro. So you can see that the subscription is of $9.99 per month, which is, if you live in India, which is around 1,000 rupees, which is affordable to all of you. Why I'm telling you that affordable, because you will come to know why. So if you have done this subscription, then you will get three most important thing that you will not get in Google Colab free version. The first important thing is that you will get a faster GPU, means you will get a high end graphic card so that you can render that particular animation of 100 frame or 400 frame easily. And the second thing is you will get longer runtime. Longer runtime means that you can run your renders for 24 hours without any interruption. But in Google free version, you can just run for 12 hours, but then also you will get some runtime outs. But okay, for start, if you are using free version, the third important thing is that you will get more memory. In Google free version, you will get just around 12 to 16 GB of RAM, but in Google Colab Pro you will get 25 GB of RAM. If you are doing some simulations which takes then the most important thing is RAM and graphic card you will get in free version. I'm going to talk about that also. So let's talk about graphic card, the most important thing in the rendering. So first that, let's talk about Google Colab free version. The graphic card that you will get in the free version is Tesla T4 and Tesla K80. So Tesla T4 and Tesla K80 are both the same graphic card, which will take around 3 minutes to render particular frame or single frame. And if you get the subscription of $9.99 equals to $10, then you will get Tesla P100 and Tesla V100, which will take somewhere to render one frame is about 30 to 1 minute, which is a very big difference if we are creating the animation, which minute is important. So now let's know about how much RAM you will get in Google Colab free version and Google Colab Pro version. VRAM means graphic card RAM. In Google Colab free version we will get just 14 GB of RAM, and in Google Colab Pro we are getting 16 GB of RAM, which is a very big difference if you know. So let's now talk about where Google Colab Pro is available. So Google Colab Pro is available in United States, Canada, Japan, Brazil, Germany, France, India and United Kingdom and Thailand. So in India also Google Colab Pro is now available. Earlier it was not available, but now it is available. So it is I want to talk to you about how much runtime. Runtime means free version will run and for how much hour the pro version will run. So for if you are free version, then I already told that it will run for 12 hours, but it can crash till 10 hours. And if you are Google Colab Pro with subscription, you will get 24 hours. You can run your renders for 24 hours. So friends, this was a basic introduction or say high-end introduction where you today came to know about how you can run your renders now free with the help of Google Colab Pro and with their servers. So now you can do your animations within a seconds. So if you like the video, do press the like button, as well as I have provided the link in the description about all the codes, you can go and check it. So in the next video I'm going to explain you that how you can do the animation of such kind of render. You can see that I have created this render from Google Colab Pro which take me around 2 hours, and some videos it take me about 4 hours. The frame rates are like for some particular render the frame rate frames were 400 frames, and some particular render the frames were 600 to 700 frames, which just took me 2 to 4 hours with Google Colab Pro. So if you want to buy this subscription, do buy it. So for this video I am stopping today, but from next video I am going to upload more videos, as well as I am to explain you how to use Blender. So do subscribe to this YouTube channel, as well as press the bell icon. So thank you for watching the video till then. So friends, bye bye, be happy, be safe, bye friends.